which can be considered as a novel. Out of these lists, we are going to study few of them so that it will be beneficial for the understanding. Before dealing with the novel dosage form, most of them are the nano-sized particles, we can say. So first of all, we must be aware about what is the size of these particles. So that's why I intentionally kept this slide for the revision or revising the concept regarding the size. The first thing is 1 centimeter is equal to, all of you are aware that 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. Now 1 millimeter is equal to 1000 micrometers. And 1 micrometer is equal to 1000 nanometers. So this part we must remember, 1 micrometer is equal to 1000 nanometer. 1 millimeter is equal to 1000 micrometer. And nanoparticles, generally they are in the range of 1-200 nanometer. So the least size count, that is 1-200 nanometer. For example, which you are aware that our visible light, so light is having wavelength around 400-700 nanometer. So we can say that the nanoparticles are far smaller, or we can say much smaller than the wavelength of visible light. So this is a quite interesting fact. So now we are going to start with our first novel dosage form. First one is liposomes. The word liposome is derived from the Greek words, or two Greek words, lipo means fat and soma means body. In some books it is also described that soma means cell or soma means body, but basically in a Greek word soma is considered as a body, or we can say several living cells other than the reproductive cell can be considered as a soma. Leave it. Now moving on, next. So liposomes are microparticulate colloidal carrier. Microparticulate. Now this range, it is in a micrometers. Hence we are going to term them as a microparticulate colloidal carrier. What is the size range? What is the diameter? The diameter of liposomes is 0.05 to 5 micrometer. 0.05 to 5 micrometer. Once again we will go back and check. 5 micrometers, 1 micrometer is equal to 1000 nanometer. So 5 micrometer is equal to how much? Very good, 5000 nanometer. And one more, that is 0.05 micrometer. 0.05, 1 micrometer is equal to 1000, 0.1 micrometer is equal to 100, and what will be 0.05? What will be? Very good. So it is 50 nanometers to 5000 nanometers in a size range, or we can simply say 0.05 micrometer to 5 micrometer. So these are the artificial microscopical vesicles. Vesicles, or we can say the smaller sacs containing one or more lipid layer. And this particular one or more lipid layer, it encloses an aqueous core. This is hydrophilic head. In the description we are again going to see that the hydrophilic head oriented towards water compartment, while lipophilic tail oriented towards the center of the vesicles or other tails. Center of vesicle, towards center or other tails. So all these are the hydrophobic tails and hydrophilic heads, or we can also say that lipophilic tails and lipophobic heads or hydrophilic heads. Thus it forms bilayer. So this reminds me, as well as this reminds you, one more concept, that is fluid mosaic model of cell membrane. So what fluid mosaic model is? They say that the cell membrane is made up of phospholipids, or we can say lipoproteins. So these are the phospholipids, their hydrophilic heads and lipophilic tails, and there are several proteins. So in the sea of lipids, there will be bulk of bunches of the proteins, as it was described. So these are hydrophilic heads and non-polar hydrophobic tails, fatty acid tails. So this is the similar with the our liposomes. So liposomes, they are having very similar structure as that of the cell membrane. So liposomes has an aqueous solution core which is surrounded by hydrophobic membrane, and hydrophilic solutes dissolve in the core, while hydrophobic chemicals associated with the bilayer. What exactly we want to say here? Any sort of drug can be incorporated or can be entrapped in a liposomes. Liposomes, these are the carriers, my dear students. Remember, liposomes are microparticulate colloidal carrier system. As such, drug is not going to dissolve in this, or not going to get delivered up to the target, but with the help of these carriers, drug can reach there. So this is the advantage of liposomes. These are the carriers. So we can incorporate hydrophilic solutes in the aqueous core, that is, which is present in the center, while hydrophobic, which is in this bilayer, because the tails are the hydrophobic. So in the same, we can incorporate hydrophilic as well as hydrophobic solutes in the liposome. Hence, a liposome can be loaded with hydrophobic or hydrophilic molecules to deliver the molecules to the site of action, as I described earlier. So the lipid bilayer can fuse with the other bilayers such as cell membrane. Just now we saw the structure of cell membrane. So the lipid bilayer can fuse with other bilayer just like cell membrane. So cell membrane is also having the lipid bilayer, and thus delivering the liposome content to the cell. And this is a complex and non-spontaneous event. So this is the advantage of liposome. The preparation of liposome is simple. Like you can isolate the lipid by using organic solvents, and the lipids are dispersed in aqueous media. Drug is loaded in a carrier by active and passive loading technique, and finally purification and evaluation of the liposomes. What are the advantages of liposome? We can say it is biocompatible as well as biodegradable, easy to prepare, or even though they can say act as a carrier of hydrophilic, hydrophobic molecules. So likewise, there are so many advantages of liposomes, as well as they can alter the pharmacokinetic properties, can easily modulate it. So this is also added advantage for the liposomes. And control release dosage form can be prepared by using these liposomes. So there are so many advantages. Talking about their application, therapeutic effect of the drug can be improved or has been improved. So the drug ampelopsin its therapeutic effect has been increased by using liposome. Paclitaxel entrapment made possible. Paclitaxel, we are all are aware, anti-cancer drug paclitaxel. So its therapeutic effect is been enhanced by entrapping it into the liposome carrier system, as well as catechins, quercetin and rutin. The all these drugs are incorporated in the liposome carrier system. So what is the advantage of quercetin and rutin? So it is going to enhance the binding of, with the hemoglobin in the form of liposomes, as well as capsaicin shows the prolonged action and enhanced permeation when it is formulated in the form of liposome. So this is the novel dosage form liposome.